Hello guys and welcome back po dito sa AutoMathThings. So for this video, pag-uusapan po natin ang related rates and yung mga basic steps kung paano po mag-solve ng mga related rates problem. So first po, kailangan nyo pong basahin, okay? Read and reread the problem. So kailangan nyo po siyang basahin ng paulit-ulit hanggang maintindihan po ninyo ang problem. Next is you have to draw a diagram. Napaka-necessary po nito para po ma-visualize natin kung ano yung sinasabi ng problem. Next, you have to express the given information and the required rate in the terms of derivatives. And hanapin din po natin kung ano yung hinahanap natin or kung ano yung gustong makuha ng problem. Five is write an equation. So kailangan na natin ng equation that relates the various quantities of the problem and then substitute all the unknown or all the known values and rates of change into the equation and solve the problem. And make sure po na, ayan, write out the indicated measure of units, especially sa final answer natin. So our first example is this one. This is very simple. It says, each side of x of a square is increasing at a constant rate of 3 inches per second. How fast is the area increasing when x is equal to 5? So, dito po makikita nyo sa first statement niya na square, okay? Yung shape na pinag-uusapan natin, yung geometric shape na pinag-uusapan natin is square. So, diba sabi dito, you have to draw a diagram. So, let's first draw a diagram. So, square. Okay, so, let's draw a square. Tapos, sabi dito, each side of x. So, meron po tayong variable. Sabi nga dito, express the given information and required rate. Okay? In terms of the derivatives. So, dito po, sabi niya, ang side po ng ating square is x. So, you can actually write here, let x, okay, be the side of the square. Okay? Kasi po, this is very important, no? To assign variables. Okay, so, bale, yung side po natin dito is x. So, bale, yung each side po ng square is x. Take note na yung side po ng ating square is equal. So, x lang po yan lahat. And take note nyo po yung word dito na increasing. Okay? Pag nakakita po kayo ng word na increasing or decreasing, it means it is changing. Yung derivative po natin na tinatawag, derivative is actually equal to change. Diba? Kaya sometimes we express that 1 to delta. So, pag nakita po natin yung word na increasing, decreasing, it means yun po ay rate of change. Okay? So, we can express that 1. We have x, the side of the square. Sabi niya, increasing at a constant rate of 3 inches per second. So, yung atin daw pong side is increasing, so dx over dt is equal to 3 inches per second. Okay? Pag nakita nyo po yung word na increasing, it means it is rate, it is changing. So that is a derivative. Okay? Then next, how fast is the area increasing? So dito, hinahanap po natin yung area. Okay? So area. Hinahanap natin si area. So find area. Okay. And area increasing when x is equal to 5. So, how fast is the area increasing? It means you have to take the derivative of the area. Okay. What is the value? What is the formula of area of the square? Area of the square is, okay, x squared. Okay. Meaning the square of your side. Okay. X squared po. Yan po yung formula ng square. Okay. Ito yung po ay formula of the area of the square. Okay? So, mas maigi na alam natin, no? Yung area, surface area, volume, para alam natin yung formula. For example, dito, square. So, alam natin yung area ng square. So, masusulat natin siya. Then, you have to take the derivative of what is asked, which is the area. So, let me rewrite this one. Area, x squared. Take the derivative. So, derivative of that one is dA over dt. derivative of both sides, so that derivative of this one is 2x dx over dt. Take note, meron po tayong given na x is equal to 5. Okay? Again, how fast is the area increasing when x is equal to 5? Okay. So, dito po natin yan i-substitute. We have dA over dt. That's 2 times x, which is sabi niya when x is equal to 5. So, 5 inches. Tapos, we have the value of dx over dt. What is the value of dx over dt? Ito po, no? That's given in the problem. 3 inches per second. So, that's 3 inches per second. So, use your calculator. Our answer po is 30 inches squared per second. Don't forget po to write the unit. Okay? Ayan siya. So, now, this is our final answer. 30 inches per second. So again, if you have first to identify what is given in the problem. So identify or set a variable. Okay, tapos identify what is given. Identify what is asked area. Sabi niya increasing. So you have to take the derivative of what is asked, which is this time is the area. So kinuha natin yung derivative niya. Pagkatapos noon, we can substitute the value. So, you have to take the derivative first before substituting the value, then calculate, you already have your answer. So, on our next video, I will be talking about another example on related rates. So, I hope meron kayong natutunan in this video. Maraming salamat and see you po on my next video.